In this section, we're going to create a trend view to see our tag logging archives. We will create a ruler control to allow us to see the instantaneous values. And you'll also be able to set a statistical range to view statistics of the points between a start and stop time. So let's get started. We're going to start in Graphics Designer and we'll open our trends page. On the trend control, we'll double click to open the settings. And we're going to add our archive tags here. So the first one is here, and that is going to be our red color. And we will attach red, and we will make it red. We'll repeat the procedure for green and blue. There's green. There's blue, and we're going to add our mixed tank level. And we'll just leave it black. And on our value axes, we will just make it range between 0 and 100 because all of our trends, that's the range for our colors and our tank level. Then I'll just click OK. We'll also want to include a ruler control. So we'll look at the name of our control here. It's control one. We can change that. And then on our controls palette, we're going to grab a ruler control and just place it down here. And the settings will come up and we will just select our trend control as a source. And it takes care of showing itself. And we'll just click OK. So next, we're just going to save. And then on the main PDL, we'll just go to runtime. While runtime is activating, you should see the tag logging runtime manager going. That's because we turned it on in WinCC Explorer. Now that we're in runtime, so I've added the tags to our simulator so that we're going to be generating some data. And then we will go to our trend screen. And we should see some trended data there. And of course, they're color coded. We can also access the configuration dialog here. Maybe make our line weights a little bigger. And if we want to take a closer look, we can hit our ruler, which shows our ruler control. And as we move our ruler, we can see the values here. We can also set the properties on our ruler control. So maybe we want to make a little bit bigger font so that we can see it. And we can also use our statistics range, which gives us a ruler to the left and a ruler to the right. And then we can hit F of X, and it gives us statistics of all the points taken between the ranges. We can also export this data directly into Excel, into a CSV sheet if we want.